So in this video, I'm going to show you how to download and install React. So first, getting started, we need to install Visual Studio Code. So why I'm using Visual Studio Code is that it really gives a good appeal while coding, and also it has many plugins that are makes our coding work much easier. So I think Visual Studio Code is the best thing to do for React or other web development programming, for JavaScript, etc. And I've already installed Visual Studio Code over here, so I have it. So you need to install it. Pretty straightforward installing .com Visual Studio code.visualstudio.com is the website. So install it. And next thing what you're going to do is we need to install Node.js. So Node.js, we are going to install React through Node Package Manager. So we need Node.js for that. So first just click the download for Node.js. So it's only about 29 MB in size. And install whichever version you are preferred with. Open. Just click next. Accept. Next. Next. And click next. It's okay. So it's also a very straightforward installation. So okay, so once Node has been successfully installed, just click finish. It takes about only 2 to 3 minutes for installing. So next thing what we are going to do is you need to go to the command prompt. CMD and hit enter, and you need to first select the folder where you're going to install React. So okay, so React is basically a library, so you need to include React in your VS Studio Code. You need to open that entire React folder in your VS Studio Code while we are going to type JavaScript, so that it's simply like we are just going to use import library something in Python. So similar, React is so similar to that, and the only thing is that you need to include a React folder also in your VS Code while typing JavaScript code. So that's what we're going to do. So for that, I am just going to go to this exec folder, C users, and so just going to go to the folder and type the following command: npm init react-app, and this one is going to be the name of the app that we're going to create. So I'm just going to keep it as my react.js. So it's JavaScript. So this one is for installing, and this one is going to be just the name of the project that I'm creating. So if now you hit enter, so as you can see here, React is getting installed. That's it. So we have successfully installed React. So it took a long time. So it would show here, we suggest you, and this happy hacking message. So that's it. So it also asks you to do this cd my react and npm start. This is to verify that whether the React has been successfully installed. So I'm already in cd my react. Okay, I'm in and npm start. Okay, and hit enter. So as you can see, I'm getting a localhost 3000, and this CSRC that app that is the main folder. So if I now open this folder in my VS Code folder, see, you're just going to go to users, and if you just go and go click my react and SRC, okay, and select folder. So this is where our things has been installed. So actually, while I was installing this, my React folder was empty, but now all the folders that the packages libraries required for functioning of React has been installed successfully. When if you go to inside node modules, and you can see here, these are the bunch of that want to say libraries and dependencies that are required for the proper functioning of React and has been fully installed. Okay, so let me check the size. It's taking a very long time to install this one. Still not getting stable. So if I just go to app.js, I think so it's yes, it's app.js, and here you can see here is that particular code, okay. Paragraph, it's in paragraph text, okay. So this code corresponds to the code that is being displayed, okay. Edit src that app.js, and so here it is, and here's that logo. This is what it makes the spin, okay. So if you aren't getting this localhost, whether there is some error in your installation. So So that's it. Thanks for watching.